We have fought as our mistress commanded us. Now we surrender to return to the woods and to restore the balance. You surrender. You're all dead. Okay, back off. Well, he's got a swarm on him or something. Miscast magic. Or Minsk does.
Sharpened and raring to go.
I mean, he's entangled, but it looks like he's covered with bugs. Him and Anoman. Anoman.
Help guides my path.
It's not Anoman. Chant, mind shield, and
the best leaders also follow.
Who says what?
Alright, we just have to leave this area. Out of the entangled stuff.
Make way, villain. Heroes coming
through. Those of us that can. I know some people really don't like Anoman, so you might be enjoying this. He's got bugs all over him.
Bad kicking for goodness.
He's missing. Minsk. That is loud. I wonder if that'll work for him. Oh, actually, I think he's fine now. Well, let's go back and see what these people have.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Nothing? No wonder they were so easy to kill. They had no armor or anything. They were just sitting around in, like, tunics and leggings and stuff. Boots. Alright, so we didn't kill him. So we might run into him again. I guess we just continue now.
All the world.
You're right behind me, right?
Oh, like some kind of stairs that used to go down into something and now it's just destroyed.
All the world is blind to my passing.
There's a pheasant there. Oh, what's that? Entrance to Adratha's cottage. Okay, we got Adratha's cottage over here.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Sure, why not? We'll go to Adratha's cottage.
You point, don't teach my hamster to suck eggs.
Do a little more reconnoiter. Ooh. Like voices?
Oh, very well. Hiya.
What stairs up? Oh. This goes up behind.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Interesting. What's the top of the map? It's So maybe a little town here, or just a few buildings?
The night hides evils that you can barely imagine. Good thing I stand ready against any who would dare to strike against us.
Yeah, it's a good thing, because we'd all be doomed without you, wouldn't we? There's a rabbit coming. Sharpened, pointy teeth.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Come full circle. Oh, Cernd is over here. Oh, crap. What the hell we got here? Spore colony over here. Alright, let's go back this way. We'll check out a Grathis cottage.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Look at on this bridge. Oh, okay. I wonder what's in there, but we can't really go there.
All the world is blind.
Unless there's a back way in, but I don't see that there is. Alright. Who's a Grathis?
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
A Drathis, yeah.
All the world is blind to my passing.
Is all the world blind to your passing? Because I wasn't sure. A Drathis. Trying to see for Craig. Because that does sound familiar. Itafir has likely replaced an old potion seller named Adratha who lives in a hut in the northeast. Okay, so the Rakshasha is in there. So maybe I think we want Cernd to come with us for that. I think that's his quest. Or related to the animals going crazy. Or they're the same thing, I'm not sure.
Swords, well, not words!
I know, Mince, let's go.
Live by the sword! Live a good long time!
All the world is blind to my passing.
He's like running rings around him. Either Cernd is going to talk to us, or we're going to attack these things. Protection from evil. Yeah, wouldn't really work. They're not evil, I don't think. Okay, so he's there, but let's see if we can deal with two spore colonies.
Go for the eyes, Yal!
Your life shall be mine.
Oh, my! 420! Why'd she say, oh my? Critical hit. Okay, she did a critical hit. Oh my, a critical hit. Oh my. Very interesting. Alright. That's almost the entire zone. We just have this area and a little strip over here. Yeah, I'll talk to him. And Anuman can keep his stuff for now. We're not going to use it. We will take it back when we're done with his quest, though. Whenever that may happen.
Your investigations have been fruitful. Let us examine them for possible solutions to this regrettable situation. Speak what you have learned of the local druids. How are they tainted?
Is it Faldorn? I'm not sure. I'm not sure if she took over. She was involved in some way. I do not have anything to tell you. You should join me so we can look together. That would be best. I know many of the druids that once frequented this area. Perhaps they will be sympathetic. Come, we must hurry to the grove. Yeah, I'm not sure where the grove is. Is that where those houses are? Yeah, he's not gonna stay for all this. Alright, let's go. Okay, so we will remove Animan until after this quest.
We must continue our travels.
No. It'll be better to split up for now. And we'll go as you bid, but we have done well together, and I should like to rejoin when you have changed your mind. I will await you at the Copper Coronet. No, don't wait for us here. We'll meet you back at the Copper Coronet if we need your services again. Animal travel. Yeah, we waited around and no one someone's supposed to show up and talk to us or give us a letter or something like that. Never happened. Well, we'll try again after all this with Cernd. I have joined with Cernd to investigate the trouble with the druids near Trade Meet. He suggests that we seek them out, as many may recognize him and give us information. Well, we've killed a lot of them. One's still alive, though. Alright, what does he have? He has a staff of the High Forest plus 2. This staff is the culmination of a cycle of seasons in which Cernd meditated on his role within nature. His perch for this personal journey was next to a sapling, a young oak that was a particular interest of study. It seemed odd and yet somehow wonderfully ordered. At the coming of spring, Cernd examined it one last time and it came loose in his hands, a living staff granted as a boon from nature herself. It has grown to fit his grip and few others may wield it. Regenerates one hit point every 2 seconds. That go plus 2, 1d6 plus 2. Damage. Cloak of the High Forest plus 1. When younger, Cernd spent a cycle of seasons meditating on his role within nature. He made no shelter, wanting to feel the land unhindered. Nature may have appreciated the intent, for she also knows that for all their dedication, at times her children can be foolish. Cernd found this cloak before the cold season set in, seemingly woven to fit him from the very undergrowth. The message was clear. He can appreciate the rain while seeking shelter from it. Only Cernd may use this cloak. Armor class plus 1 and saving throw plus 1. Cool. Alright, do we have anything even better we can give him? Oh, he gave back his Flail of the Ages. I was going to let him keep that. Yeah, Druid can't use. I don't remember what this is for. See, some kind of quest item. Did Cernd give it back to us? I remember things being like these three and then these four. Halfling's Help Belure. I mean, I do remember it. Miranda. Oh, Beatrice Pub. This one's supposed to give that to somebody. It's kind of heavy. Oh, he can level up. Oh, shapeshifter. Can he use that spear? We did find that special spear. shapeshifter. This druid is not called shapeshifter because she has or he has access to a great variety of forms, but rather because of his complete dedication to a single alternate form. This druid has willingly allowed himself to become infected with lycanthropy, but due to intense study and training, he has the ability to control his affliction. The creature he becomes is that of the werewolf, the most famous of the lycanthrope shape changers. May shapeshift into the form of a werewolf once per day, gains one use at level 1 and an additional use every 2 levels thereafter. And a 13 level may shapeshift into a greater werewolf once per day. Disadvantages: may not wear any armor, no other shapeshifting penalties due to the effort required in maintaining balance in his primary forms. Alright, so that's why he's not wearing armor. Well. So we're not going to bother giving him any armor then. Good to know. Wait a second, what about his biography? Kit description. Information. When asked about his past, Cernd declares in a steady and modest tone that it has been his honor to serve nature in whatever capacity she did call upon him. It is clear that he is a dedicated servant, and although his demeanor is contemplative and well-measured, you are certain that he would not hesitate to risk himself if it would best serve the greater balance. Yeah, well, the greater balance ain't all cracked up to be. I mean, just look at Thanos, for example. So, Spear of the Unicorn. According to this, monk can use. So this is a plus 2 weapon versus his plus 1. Maybe he can wear the protector. Maybe he'll want Neb's head. Braces of defense AC 7. Also checking to see if we have any weapons that are plus 3. I mean, this bow, sure. This might be even better. My backpack's full. Here. I don't think you can use it. Cannot use item. Okay. Yeah, you want that, huh, buddy? To get some down to AC 6, 5. Where's that weird little thing? Dragon's Bane. Not usable by Druid. It said no armor. What about shields? Oh, this is a +2 shield. You can't use it. Nope. This is a dagger. And this is a proficiency type spear and dagger. I don't think he has. No, he's not proficient. Oh, he is proficient in dagger. And a sling. How many slings left? Oh, that's a good one. Immunity to charm and domination. Well, really? Is this the thing we gave to him? So maybe. This is great, though. 3d6 damage. I can't. I mean, he should hold on to it in case we come across, you know, mind controlling creatures. Just looking if other people got random stuff that Cernd dropped when he left the group. Yeah, this is a bad idea because of, friendly fire and silence. What if I duel, have him dual wield Spear of the Unicorn and Pixie Prick? He's not going to use this, is he? It's just going to sit there. Because when we look at Minsk, oh, I don't know. Maybe he is dual wielding it. Oh, it says offhand Thaco Daystar. Yeah, I don't think a druid can do a wield, actually. Not really a master of. Oh, that stuff, so. I mean, I like that. Falling asleep for 2 rounds. 1d4 plus 3, or 1d6 plus 2. So, 3 to 8, or 4 to 7? No, 4 to, yeah, 4 to 7. All right, I'll have him use this. I'll put this near. So this does the poison and falling asleep thing. Okay. wonder if you have any boots, belts, rings, or helmets. Can't wear armor. Can't use shield. Boots, belts, or rings, or helmets. See if we can help him out here. Oops. I gave him some kind of circlet already. It's only usable by shaman. Anyway. That might include a helmet. Well, I don't know. There's people like mages. We have mages wearing helmets. So he should be able to wear it. This is a hairband. I don't think he wants that. Yeah, we don't have many boots and miscellaneous stuff like that. You can use a sling. I have a sling plus one. Helm of the Noble. You should be able to use it. Armor class and charisma plus one. He already has a cloak. Okay. That's it. We don't have any boots or belts. Sorry, guy. No boots. No belts. We have bootless and beltless. Here, have that. Have that. We got his armor class down to 4 now. You're also gonna need some bullets, aren't you? Well, that's the problem. We're kind of running low on them. Oops. I can't put that back now. Okay.
Fine.
Stand back for justice!
Where are you going?
Such menial tasks.
Maybe the Druid Grove is in here.
Battle bow! Run, bow, run!
All the Yukata.
Okay, welcome, Cernd. Hope you don't regret the experience. Oops.
All the world is blind to my passing.
There's a shadow druid and someone by the name of Daylock over there.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
I don't think they're evil. So protection from evil wouldn't make sense to cast. Maybe some haste just in case.
But kicking for goodness!
Whatever you need, I do it well.
Even in the darkest hours, nature is awake. Would that more of us had the eyes to see.
Haste just in case. I know that almost rhymes, but not quite.
Simple matter.
Let's give us the edge over these guys.
Where Minsk goes, evil.
It would be good for you to watch your actions while in this wood.
Death to the enemies of nature! In Faldorin's name, we cleanse the earth of you. All will fear where shadow druids tread. I have been attacked by a druid proclaiming that I should die in Faldorin's name. She is apparently a shadow druid. Well, we're hasted, you fool! Watch, there's like 10 more back here. Begin the assault. Oh, maybe not. Hold up. Because they're all gonna run in No?
Yes?
Boop.
Your life
is in the hand of justice!
So yeah, two more Shadow Druids. That takes care of him, that was quick. Enchanted longsword and club. Oh, adherent. We have an adherent.
Your life.
Death to the adherent. I thought I switched her.
Fine.
Was it because I don't have anything in the first slot? Is that why? Is that why? I probably could have held it down, but. Yeah, that's why. Watch for that.
Strange things go bump in the night, but none bump bigger than Minsk.
Yeah, I didn't want that. Oh, that's me? Okay. Now, who picked up that other stuff? You did? Okay. Hand it over! Nasher plus two. Macal of the Pine, a devious druid, carved this club and bonded it with the spirit of his wolverine companion. Like that tenacious creature, Nasher is a dangerous weapon in the hand of a skilled user. When the club strikes, sharp splinters dig into the victim's flesh, causing extreme pain and even extra damage that continues for some time after the blow. Macal used the club successfully on several occasions, earning the anger of orc loggers threatening his forests. Thaco plus two. Damage is 1d6 plus two. Slivers add 2 points piercing damage each round for 4 rounds. Wow. Pretty good club. So put it in there. And this we don't know. I'm gonna have area identify. Oh. I think Minsk had this at one point, didn't he? The Burning Earth plus one. I think in the first Baldur's Gate, he had it. Flame Tongue plus one, the Burning Earth. There was a time before Neverwinter was warm and before the Great Anorak was dry, or so it is said. Few relics remain to prove such an age existed, and fewer still have an identifiable purpose. The Burning Earth seems straightforward enough. It burns a victim with magical fire, and a cryptic rune seems to suggest that the power comes from the ground itself. But whomever constructed it remains a mystery. It looks a perfectly serviceable weapon, but something in the balance or grip is wrong. It strains the forearm a touch, and it does not fit the hand just right. It doesn't seem to hurt a warrior's performance, aside from the nagging doubt that the blade was not made for her or any other humanoid. Thaco plus one, plus two versus regenerating creatures like trolls, plus three versus cold-using creatures, plus four versus undead. Damage is 1d8 plus 1, plus 1 fire damage, plus 2 versus regenerating creatures, plus 3 versus cold creatures, and plus 4 versus undead. It's a pretty interesting weapon, but it's only, well, it's only effective in this case, because a lot of things we come across at this point can't even be hurt by plus 1 weapons. So undead, cold creatures, and regenerating. Great, but otherwise... Yoshimo can use it. What's he using? Yeah, he has a +2 weapon. Extra attack per round. I don't remember this stuff half the time. Well, Cernd, that could have gone better.